Hey, do you have a YouTuber or a streamer or a podcaster on your holiday shopping list and they're really difficult to shop for and you're looking to get some sort of microphone or some fun audio gift? Or maybe you're a content creator yourself and you just wanna, you know, pick up something fun at the holidays. Well, I put this microphone holiday buying guide together just for you, just to make your life a little bit easier. Man, I have reviewed a lot of microphones this year and I've actually tested quite a few more because not every microphone I test actually makes it into a review. If I get a bad microphone, I don't review it. So I only review microphones that I would recommend to you. So what I've decided to do is make kind of a best of the best list where I go through and I think about, okay, what are all the best microphones in a particular category? So my goal here is to talk about microphones that are reasonably affordable. And I've divided it into two tiers. Basically, I have a budget tier, which is $100 or less. And then I have a more premium tier, but we're talking maybe $300, something like that. I'm not going to talk about microphones that are $2,000 because that's a tough gift to give for most people. Now, you absolutely do not have to do this, but I have affiliate links for all of these microphones in the video notes. And I mean, if you're like me, you appreciate having everything in one spot and it just being kind of convenient. So check them out if you want to. So I've divided up this video into four microphone categories: condenser microphones, dynamic microphones, shotgun microphones, and wireless microphones. And yeah, I could have, like, you know, added headset microphones and I've done a whole section on USB microphones or really exotic microphones, but you know, I gotta draw the line somewhere and it's already going to be quite a long video. By the way, I have put chapters in the video, so if you just want to skip to a particular section, be my guest. Okay, quick disclaimer here. Now, in the original review videos, I did have some manufacturers send me microphones either on a loaner basis or even sent them to me for free, but at no point was I paid to make a review. I could say whatever I want in the original review, and nobody is paying me to do this buyer's guide. In fact, I mean, nobody even knows I'm doing it. Well, I mean, you know I'm doing it now. And I guess the manufacturers don't, but nobody knew ahead of time. All right, let's talk about condenser microphones. Now, first, I did review recently a couple of microphones from Fifine, and one was a condenser microphone, one was a dynamic microphone, and the condenser microphone kind of stood out to me. And what really stood out was the price point. These microphones are under $40 each. And the condenser microphone, you know, for that price, sounds pretty good. Now, I do recommend getting a pop filter for it because it's very sensitive to plosives, but let's take a listen to that microphone. So we are listening to the K669C, which is the condenser version, and it's a side address mic. There's a logo that indicates the front of the mic, so make sure that's pointing at you. And a nice touch is that you can rotate the mic and the mic clip, so it's easy to position it however you want. When I'm recording, I'm usually right up on a mic, like an inch away from the grill, and this helps cut down on room sound, and it also adds some proximity effect. However, I think the K669C sounds better if I back off a little bit. My voice just sounds, I don't know, more natural if it's about a fist away. So if I get too close, it sounds a little boomy. Each mic comes with a mic clip and a very small table stand, like this. What these mics are both lacking, though, and you might be able to hear it as I'm talking, is a pop filter. You really want a pop filter whenever you use a mic with vocals or spoken word. Not just to reduce pops or plosives, but because it keeps the spit off the mic. So you'll need to buy a pop filter separately, but I mean, hey, you just saved a ton of money on the mic.
Earlier this year, I made a video where I compared $200 microphones to each other. I put them up head to head, compared them with features and sound quality. Now, one of them is a really, really popular microphone. The other microphone is the one I recommend, and it's the SE Electronics X1A. And what I did is I've taken that review video and I've kind of made a compilation of it just so that you can get a sense of that microphone.
This is the X1A. It's got two switches. It's got a 20 dB pad. In case you got a really loud sound source, you can knock it back 20 dB. And it's also got a high pass filter, so you can roll off the low end at 100 Hertz, and that's really handy. Okay, now I'm gonna do a plosive test, and condenser microphones are really sensitive to plosives, which is why you usually use a pop filter with them. So I'm expecting them both to respond kind of negatively to plosives. Now, up until now, I've been speaking sort of through this gap between the two microphones. They're a little bit off axis, so they're not getting the full brunt of my plosive sounds, but now I'm gonna go directly onto each microphone.
Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. So from that test, what I've noticed is that the X1A seems to have a richer, beefier low end, and also it doesn't respond to plosives very much. It turns out the X1A has a built-in pop filter. Having an internal pop filter is really convenient, and it has some serious implications for streamers and podcasters and anyone who's on camera, because you don't have to worry about having an external pop filter necessarily.
All right, I'm already breaking my rule here because I'm gonna throw in a bonus condenser microphone. This is the Lauten Audio LA-220. Now, it is more than $300, but it's such a nice microphone. And it's still considered a budget microphone, but with the price getting up there, I realize it's not affordable for everyone. So let's check that out.
Today, I'm reviewing the LA-220 condenser microphone from Lauten Audio, and spoiler alert, it is a lovely microphone. The microphone itself is really nice looking too. It feels sturdy. It's got this tapered cylinder body. The head basket, that's the screen thing on top, this feels really sturdy too. I don't think you're gonna dent it in day-to-day use. This microphone has two switches on it. They have a low roll-off filter, and it rolls off at 120 hertz, but they also have a high roll-off filter, and that rolls off at 12 kilohertz. So let me demonstrate now how these filters sound. Right now you're hearing it flat, there's no switches engaged, and now I'm going to engage the low roll-off filter that rolls off at 120 hertz. Now you're listening to the LA-220 with the 120 hertz low roll-off filter, or high-pass filter if you prefer to call it that. So now we're back to flat just for reference, and I'm going to engage the high roll-off filter, and again we're rolling off at 12 kilohertz here. And this is how the microphone sounds with rolling off the high end at 12 kilohertz. The maximum SPL that this can handle is 130 dB. And if you compare that to the Neumann U87 AI, that can only handle 117 dB. So people seem to muddle along with the U87 quite well. I don't think you're gonna have a problem with this. You may have noticed I'm not using a pop filter on this microphone. And I was comparing this microphone to another large diaphragm condenser microphone the other day. And I noticed that the other microphone was just getting crushed with plosives, whereas this microphone handles them quite well. So I reached out to Lauten and I said, hey, is there any sort of windscreen or pop filter built into it? Because it's doing a really good job of plosives without using a pop filter. And they responded saying, nope, there's no pop filter in there, no windscreen. It's just partly their capsule design, partly the head basket design. And oh, by the way, I should always use a pop filter with condenser microphones.
All right, let's talk about shotgun microphones now. And specifically, I'm talking about on-camera shotgun microphones. Now, the market for shotgun microphones, on-camera ones, is really, really saturated. There are so many different types of microphones out there, so many manufacturers. But there were a couple of microphones that really stood out to me, both on the sound quality, because that's the most important thing, the features, and the price. Now, the first one, I guess, I'm breaking my rule again. It's over $100. It's $160. But it's the Mackie EM-98MS. Not a great name, but it is a great microphone. And what I've done is I've put a little compilation here. Let's check out that microphone and see how it sounds.
Today on my camera, I have a brand new shotgun microphone. It's made by Mackie. It's the EM-98MS. The shotgun microphone from Mackie has a lot of interesting features. One thing the Mackie microphone has that other smaller, cheaper shotgun microphones don't have is a gain control. So you can fine tune the gain of the sound going into your camera. There's also a low roll-off filter that you can engage. So if you are having some wind rumbling or something else where you want to cut down those low frequencies, you can do it right there on the microphone. And that way you don't overload your limiter, you don't distort your microphone and things like that. So, and you have two choices too. You can roll off at 75 hertz or 150 hertz. So let's hear 75 hertz. All right, we are rolling off at 75 hertz on the Mackie microphone. You probably notice a little bit of low frequency loss there, and that's the whole point of the filter. Now let's hear 150 hertz. So now you're hearing the microphone rolling off at 150 hertz, and it's probably a bit more extreme. You probably notice it a lot more, and let's go back to normal. Another interesting feature of this microphone that I haven't seen on a whole lot of on-camera microphones is a safety channel feature. With the push of a button, you can, instead of recording the same level on both left and right channels, you can record a normal level on one channel and a reduced gain version of that on another channel. That way, if you overload your camera's input, you got a safety.
All right, so the premium
shotgun microphone selection for this buyer's guide is the JOBY Wavo PRO. And it's almost twice as much. It goes for about $300. And, you know, it's a much smaller microphone. If it didn't have all the features, you would say, oh, it's a mini shotgun microphone. I mean, it is mini size, but it has so many features and it sounds really good. I don't know how they put such a good sounding microphone in a small package. Here, let's check that out.
Hey, did you notice with this JOBY Wavo Pro that I've got another microphone plugged into the side?
Yeah, you got a mic on your shirt. Are you like a pro interviewer now?
Yeah, it's a little lavalier mic, and it allows me to plug that in. And that way I can have my mic signal on one channel and your signal will be on the other channel through the JOBY.
You also have a power button on the back that acts as a metering system. It's green when you have signal and yellow and red when you're about to clip. The Wavo Pro actually comes with an app, and you connect to the app via Bluetooth, and it unlocks features that you can't access from the microphone itself. For example, there's a slider so you can control the gain of the microphone, and there's all sorts of other features too. It has a low cut filter, but it also has low, mid, and high EQ built in with the app. One of the microphones I showed you earlier has a safety channel option, and what that means is it records the audio at the normal level on one channel, and on the other channel, your audio is 10 dB down. That way, if you manage to clip your levels on your camera accidentally, you have that safety channel as a backup, and you can use that instead. So the JOBY Wavo Pro has that as well, and you can turn that on either via the back of the camera or via the app. Now, there's one feature that is only available using the app, and that is noise reduction. Now, JOBY says that the noise reduction is designed to reduce handling noise when you're operating your camera, like if you're walking or you have it on a monopod or something like that. So I'm going to turn on the noise reduction now and we can give it a quick test. And I'm going to do that via the app. Okay, the noise reduction is on now, and I have this on a monopod, but you can get a sense of how it sounds. All right, so that is what the internal noise reduction sounds like. This microphone comes with a pop filter, which you'll probably never remove. It also comes with a really substantial dead cat, which I have on the microphone right now. All right, let's talk about dynamic microphones now. And I've got two selections for you. And earlier this year, I finally got around to reviewing the Zoom ZDM1. And I say finally because I've owned it for over a year already and I've been using it and I just never got around to reviewing it. And then I've finally settled that. It's a $50 dynamic microphone, which sounds pretty cheap. It sounds pretty good. So let's check that one out. This is the Zoom ZDM1. It's a dynamic microphone, much like the Shure SM7B, the Electro Voice RE20, or the Rode PodMic. But unlike those more expensive mics, the ZDM1 is only $50. And that's not a sale price, that's what it says on their website. The ZDM1 has built-in shock absorption, so you can move it around without the handling noise just completely destroying your recording. Now, I don't recommend hand-holding this mic because you'll get some noise regardless, but you could, and if you have it on a desk boom, for example, you can move the boom around without having to worry too much about, you know, like thumps and bumps. So far, I've been really eating this microphone. In other words, it's right up against my lips. But if I back off a little bit and increase the volume. Okay, so I'm about a fist away here in terms of distance, and so the low end is probably pretty significantly different, even from this short distance. The ZDM1 does come with a foam pop filter, and I recommend using this even if you're not having problems with pops and plosives. And the reason is that it protects your mic. So let's do some plosive tests, though, with and without the pop filter. Okay, so this is how the microphone sounds without the pop filter, and I'm trying to stay about the same distance. And so if I'm looking directly at the camera, Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. All right, now I'm going to go right onto the mic here. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. How'd it do? I'm just looking at my meters there, my waveform. That doesn't look too bad. I'll have to listen back to it. Okay, with the pop filter on, pointing at the camera, so I'm offset from the mic a little bit. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. All right, right down the throat of the mic. Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. All right, the premium option for dynamic microphones, and it is really, really premium. And I don't mean price-wise. It goes for just under $300. But just in terms of sound quality, oh, it's awesome. And it's designed to compete with things like the Shure SM7B. It doesn't sound exactly like the SM7B, but it really, really captures that broadcast, podcast sound quality. And it's the SC Electronics DynaCaster. Here, let's check that out. The biggest difference between the DynaCaster and traditional broadcast microphones is it has a built-in preamp. Traditional broadcast microphones are dynamic microphones, just like this is. However, dynamic microphones don't put out a lot of output level compared to a condenser microphone because there's no internal amplification. A flip of one of those dip switches on the back fires up the internal booster, and you do need phantom power to operate that booster, but most mixers supply phantom power. Okay, so how does the SE Electronics DynaCaster sound? Well, I mean, how do you want it to sound? And I say that because with those EQ switches in the back, you've got a lot of options. You can really tailor this microphone to sound how you want it. Okay, so let's take a listen to the EQ options. This is flat in both the high and the low end. And now this is the DynaCaster with the low end rolled off. And now you're hearing the microphone with the low end boost. And just for reference, this is flat again. And now I have the mild high end boost turned on. And now I have the extreme high end turned on. I don't know what to call it. It's just the extra boost there. And now I have the low end and the mild high end both boosted. So you're kind of getting that podcasty, broadcasty sound. All right, now we have it in super scoop mode. We've got the low end boosted, we've got the high end boosted, and it is very much in your face and very hyped. The DynaCaster also comes with a foam pop filter, and so I'm going to demonstrate how this microphone sounds with the pop filter on. Now this is the microphone set to flat with the pop filter on, and pop filters do tend to remove a little bit of the high frequency information. Now as I showed you, the DynaCaster does come with a pop filter, but unlike condenser microphones, you might not need it. And the reason is this microphone actually has three layers of pop filter protection built right into the microphone. So depending on your mic technique, you might not have any pops and plosives at all. And check this out. You can actually take the head basket off, that's what these things are, and wash them. Now, it's not dishwasher safe, you can't throw them in the dishwasher, but you can rinse them out and you can clean all that spit that builds up over the years. I love that SE Electronics is thinking about the future, the long term of being able to take care of your microphone. All right, next up is wireless microphones. And if you thought shotgun microphones was a really, really saturated category, wireless mics, there are so many different types, so many manufacturers, and wireless microphones are really hard to do correctly. I have heard so many bad wireless mics, noisy, and they're small, so you get, you know, making a little tiny microphone sound good is really, really difficult. Fortunately, we've got some good mics out there. I've got a budget one, and I've got a premium one as well. And the budget one I want to tell you about is the BOYA M1V2 series. Let's check that out right now. BOYA recently sent me one of their wireless microphone systems. It's the M1V2, and it goes for about $100. There's two transmitters for the price of, well, maybe not for the price of one, but you get two transmitters and one receiver. Now, there's not a lot of visual feedback with these. In fact, there's only a single LED light. Now, that light will blink blue if it's not synchronized with the transmitter and receiver. It'll be solid blue if it's working okay. It'll be red if it's charging. It'll blink red if it's running out of battery, and it'll turn green if noise canceling is on. Now, what you don't have are meters. So you really don't know how loud things are unless you have meters on your camera or on your phone. The M1 V2 does not come with a lavalier mic, but it does come with an input. So if you have a lavalier mic, or you pick up one, a cheap one for 10, 15, 20 bucks or something like that, then you can use that with these transmitters. Both transmitters come with dead cats, which is vital, which is essential if you are recording outdoors. The slightest breeze and you will hear rumbling. Actually, there's one other feature that the M1 V2 has, and that is noise canceling or noise reduction. Now, I think it's probably, there's cars going by. It would have been nice if we'd canceled that car. So I'm gonna turn on Finn's noise canceling here. And when you turn noise canceling on, the LED turns from blue to green. So noise canceling is engaged now, and if I stop talking for a sec, is it absolutely quiet? Here, Finn, you say something too.
Hello.
It's been my experience that these transmitters can transmit from a pretty decent distance. In fact, they can transmit so far that you would probably never really use it that way.
Can you hear me now?
All right, he's gonna move to the next station here.
Can you hear me now? I'm talking. Can you hear it?
Now, for the premium choice in this buyer's guide, This wireless microphone system is really unlike anything else I have ever seen in a wireless microphone. I mean, it's got a touchscreen. You can put pictures and images on it and stuff like that. And it really sounds good too. So if I'm gonna use a wireless microphone, this is the one I reach for like 95% of the time. And it's the Saramonic Blink Me. This is a wireless microphone system. It is the Blink Me from Saramonic. And yes, it has a touchscreen. And yes, you can customize that with any image you want. But this microphone system, it goes way beyond that. The Blink Me system comes with two transmitters and one receiver. And the transmitters attach to everything using magnets. You can see on my shirt right here, there's actually a magnet behind my shirt holding it in place. And there's also a traditional clip you can use, but the transmitter attaches to that magnetically as well. The transmitter units even lock into the receiver unit magnetically, where they can charge and they can do other things as well. And that's one way that the Blink Me simplifies your workflow, because you don't have to plug in three different devices to charge up. You just plug in the receiver unit and then you attach the transmitters to the receiver. It all charges on one cable. Most of the controls are accessed from the touch screen. You can adjust the microphone gain. You can start and stop recording. You can adjust the brightness on the screen. You can set a screensaver if you don't want to have it on all the time. And you can lock the screen in case you accidentally hit it when you didn't want to. And yes, these transmitters have a built-in recorder. You can use that recorder as a backup, or you can use it as your main recorder and just sync it up with your video later on. Now, if you're recording internally, you've got a choice of 16-bit or 24-bit. Each of the transmitters has noise reduction built into it. You can turn that on and off with the yellow button. Here, let me turn that on so you can hear it. Okay, the noise reduction's on right now. Now, each of these units comes with a dead cat. If you're doing any recording outside with even the slightest of breeze, you want a dead cat. All right, let me turn the noise reduction back off now. Now, the receiver unit has a touch screen as well, but it's smaller and it's on the side. The receiver unit actually magnetically attaches to an accessory shoe or a cold shoe mount, and then that attaches to your camera. And you can also select mono, stereo, or there's a mono mode with a safety channel that's 5 dB less on the other channel. Now, there is one microphone that defies categorization. It doesn't fit into any of these categories. I've never seen anything like it. It's bizarre. It's amazing. It doesn't seem like it's possible. In fact, it's an impossible mic. And you can see that review right here.